combined film careers add up to 81 years, and they're both multi-Academy Award-winning actors. Yet Meryl Streep and Tom Hanks have never appeared on screen together until now. Meryl and Tom star in the new Steven Spielberg political drama, The Post. The film is based on the unlikely partnership between a newspaper publisher and her hard-working editor. And if the reviews are anything to believe, Streep and Hanks need to make room on their mantelpiece for yet another golden statuette. Have a look.
This is a devastating security breach
that was leaked out of the Pentagon.
The most highly classified documents of the war.
The Times has 7,000 pages detailing how the White House has been lying about the Vietnam War for 30 years.
The way they lied, those days have to be over.
Set during the Vietnam War, The Post tells the story of the Washington Post publisher, Catherine Graham, and editor, Ben Bradley, as they battle the US government to publish the Pentagon Papers, a secret study which showed the long history of American meddling in Vietnamese politics.
And it showed that we were really fighting an illegal war, and an unwinnable war, a war that the study kind of stated was unwinnable. And yet we fought on.
Graham inherited the newspaper after the death of her husband, and she faced numerous obstacles as she struggled to make her way in a man's world.
Her father gave it to her husband, and her husband is no longer there, and so she is officially the person who was in charge of not just the newspaper, but the entire media empire, but she didn't know how to do it.
She was someone very unsure of herself and not born to manage a major company, and also she was the product of her time, where women weren't expected to do much outside the realm of good works, good child raising, and household keeping.
If you publish, we'll be at the Supreme Court next week.
Meaning?
Well, we could all go to prison.
Graham risked imprisonment after giving the go-ahead to Bradley to defy an injunction by the Nixon White House and publish the papers.
It was an extremely dangerous call at the time. Now it's like, you know, you can print almost anything and nobody says boo. But at that point, that brand of truth was so volatile that they didn't know if cops were going to come knocking on their doors or if the federal marshals were going to come in and smash up the printing presses in order to keep them going. And Ben Bradley didn't know if he would have a job or if he would have a convict serial number on his chest when it was all done. It's amazing that so much was at stake over printing the truth as it had existed for decades on these other pieces of paper.
The Post is the fifth film Tom Hanks has worked with Steven Spielberg, but it's hard to believe this is the first time Hanks has shared the screen with Streep.
Tom is, everyone knows, you know, he's got the reputation for being the nicest guy in Hollywood. And he's very nice, but he's also really smart. He's crackerjack smart. That's a thing that's just, I think, probably he shared with Ben Bradley. It's such an attractive quality how just a few steps ahead of everybody he is in the room.
Meryl, or as I call her, Miss Streep, she has three or four moments of pure cinema that are magnified by the place that they come in the movie. It's one thing to have a cool line and a cool shot and have a cool beat in a movie, but it's something else in order to have them play out when the entire movie is hanging in balance and you're on the edge of your seat.
You know what my husband said about the news? He called it the first rough draft of history.
I cannot imagine anybody else playing Catherine Graham the way Meryl Streep acquitted the nature of her character and plumbed the depths of her life in under 2 hours. I don't know how Meryl did it, and I'm the director.
Although set in 1971, The Post is being called the most timely film of the past 12 months and is set to inspire a new generation of women.
I think what makes the story really empowering for women today is you watch Catherine Graham grow into the job. You know, she's entitled, she's empowered with tremendous authority, which she doesn't use all the time. It's almost like that she is in a room assisting the person who is supposed to be doing her job because she hadn't yet found her voice. And it was great within this span of time and through this huge event of whether to publish or not publish the Pentagon Papers, you got to watch this woman find her voice.
Do you have the papers?
Not yet.
There just weren't very many women at all in any positions of power anywhere. And I shouldn't even use that word, power. It's a matter of moving history, changing history. There were very few women in business, very few women in law. There was no one on the Supreme Court. Women were still a little bit invisible at that point in time. And the focus of history came to rest on this particular woman's shoulders.
She can't do this.
The legacy of the company is at stake.
What will happen if we don't publish? We will lose. The country will lose.
What are you going to do, Mrs. Graham?
I can't wait.
I know. What a team, hey. I don't think that any of those three people could do anything wrong. The Post lands in cinemas this Thursday, and good news, at least for everybody in our audience, because you're all going home with a double pass to the Post. Yay! Which opens this Thursday right around the country, you lucky things.
Amazing, yeah. Give it to your kids. You can show them what newspapers used to be like.
Loved that, didn't you, Arta?
Yeah, that was very nostalgic, looking at those presses. Mm. Oh, gosh.
And yeah.
Did you takes me back.
Were you ever in the same room as her at any time?
No, I wish I had been.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, phenomenal. Mm.
Here's a double pass, Ita.
There you go. You have the next best thing.
Thank you very much.